A low-pressure area has been spotted off Sorsogon. Let's get an update now on the weather with Pag-asa's Anna Clorin Horda. Anna, over to you.
Yes, good afternoon, Ma'am Carmina. We have a low-pressure area located at around 385 kilometers east of Borangan City, Eastern Visayas. It is embedded along the intertropical convergence zone, which is now affecting the Southern Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. So for today's weather, we are expecting a cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over the Visayas, Caraga, Bicol region, Palawan, Quezon, Aurora, Isabela, and Cagayan. Here in Metro Manila and the rest of the country, we're expecting a generally fair weather condition aside from isolated rain showers mostly in the afternoon or in the evening. Based on our latest scenario here in the LPA, we're not expected that this LPA will develop into a tropical depression and may dissipate within the next 24 to 48 hours. And that's the latest from Pag-asa. This is Anna Clorin Horda. Good afternoon.
Thanks a lot, Anna. Take care. Keep safe to you and the rest of the team there. We really appreciate the work that you do. Back in the newsroom, we have this just in. 7 soldiers were wounded in a blast in Mapanas. That's in northern Samar. Our very own Bianca Davao joins us with details. Bianca, what more can you tell us?
Hi, Carmina. 7 soldiers were wounded in a roadside blast in Barangay Magsaysay, Mapanas, in northern Samar on Tuesday morning. 2 of the soldiers are in critical condition, according to the Philippine Army's 8th Infantry Division. 8ID Commander Major General Edgardo De Leon said the soldiers were doing community service in the area around 6:15 a.m. when the blast took place. He said rebels in the area are suspected to be behind the attack. De Leon denounced what he says is the continuous use of anti-personnel mines planted by communist rebels. The wounded soldiers were evacuated from the area by helicopters and are now at the Eastern Visayas Regional Medical Center in Tacloban City. Air assets and additional personnel have been deployed in the area to pursue the rebels. Carmina?
Right. Do we know, Bianca, how many are now being pursued?
As of now, we don't have the number yet of the communist rebels, Carmina. Right now, what we have is the number of wounded soldiers. That's at 7, with 2 of them in critical condition.
And how has this affected the community there, Bianca?
Based on the initial information from Major General De Leon, it's a good thing that there were no civilians in the area when the blast took place at around 6:15 a.m., Carmina.
And because of what happened, Bianca, are they also scouring the area for other possible landmines?
That's right, Carmina, because at around 6:15 a.m. when the blast took place, the soldiers were actually doing clearing operations and a community service clearing operations because of information that there were indeed anti-personnel mines planted in the area.
Mm-hmm. All right. So this story continues to develop. We're going to try and get back to you, Bianca, for more on this story in our succeeding newscast. In the meantime, thanks for joining us this afternoon. Really appreciate it. Back here in the newsroom, ABS-CBN and the Ayala Corporation set a goal to plant 160,000 trees at the Lamesa watershed with the help of e-wallet service GCash. Zian Ambrosio has that story.
Top officials of ABS-CBN and the Ayala Corporation were special guests at the Lamesa Eco Park in Quezon City Monday. They were taught how to plant lago or the broadleaf tree. Among them were ABS-CBN Corporation Chairman Mark Lopez, ABS-CBN Foundation Managing Director Berta Lopez Feliciano, ABS-CBN Foundation Director for Advocacy Ernie Lopez, Jaime Augusto Zobel de Ayala of Ayala Corporation, and GCash officials.
Po natin na ma-break yung lupa o madurog po yung lupa dahil bababa po yung survival rate niya.
They have a common goal of planting 160,000 trees in 200 hectares at the Lamesa watershed until 2023 and 2.3 million trees in the whole country.
Sana you join us all in this support and push for a greener world. And it doesn't take much. Just use the app, and through that usage of the app, other organizations can benefit from it.
With all your support today, we look forward to reaching our goal of 2.3 million trees by 2023. Sa ating bayanihan para sa kalikasan, malayo ang mararating natin para sa ating bansa.
Since 1999, 1,500 hectares of the watershed have gone through reforestation through the efforts of the foundation and its donors. the public is encouraged to donate and participate in planting more trees through the G-Forest, one of the newest features in the GCash app. This is a sustainability feature which encourages reforestation in the whole country.
Through G-Forest, mayroon nagdo-donate ng rewards points at kami ang nagkaka-benefit, yung mga foundation at iba-iba pang organization.
The ABS-CBN Foundation believes that through the joint efforts of private organizations and different sectors of society, the country can achieve environmental conservation. Z. Ana Brosho, ABS-CBN News.